So you've made it to Moonrise Tower, and you're wondering how you're going to free all these people trapped in the prison so you can be a good hero and everyone can feel all warm and fuzzy inside. This method will avoid any combat encounter and clear out the prison of all NPCs other than the scrying eyes. It'll also get you a tadpole. All you need is a way to create darkness and two bombs or a similar damaging item. So let's get started. You're going to want to take one character with bombs around the back of the prison while the others can hang out in front. There's two ways to do that. I chose the method of jumping down this awesome bottomless pit during my first time through the tower, getting some tadpole friends, and sneaking past a really scary to solo hook horror before coming up this wall behind the prison cells. A quicker and slightly safer, boring way is to take a character with high strength like Karlak and jump up this ledge here. Once you're back here, you can now begin phase two. Position your bombardier behind one of the two cell walls and get ready to throw. Switch to your darkness character and wait for the enemies to patrol to a good position where they aren't looking directly at the front of the cell. Then enter turn-based mode and cast darkness. To see their vision cones, hold shift on PC by default or R3 on a controller by default. While you can technically do it without the darkness, it helps cover the people escaping from being noticed if someone turns around at the last second. It seems they'll notice the people running away, but won't notice that there are no people. Makes perfect sense. Once you have cast darkness on the front of the cell, switch back to your bombardier and lob it at the wall, which should blow up easily and the people inside will take the opportunity to dash away. Repeat this process for the other cell, and there you have it. Zero combat required to get this achievement, saving everybody and clearing out the prison. You can choose to take the boat back with everyone, which I personally did, collecting the rewards and then porting the rest of the group back. Now, depending on your choices in Act 1, there may be more or less people than I had in mind. If you're trying to recruit Minthara, for example, and have met up with her for the first time in Act 2, she may be down here. The Tieflings may also not be present depending on your choices in Act 1. From what I've read on this, it doesn't matter who you save, it matters if you save everybody who is present. Now obviously I can't test this because I already have the achievement, but multiple people have confirmed this on the internet, and as you know, nothing on the internet is ever wrong, ever. I hope you enjoyed this video, fellow adventurer. If you're looking for more helpful content for Baldur's Gate 3, click here to check out this video on a ton more helpful items and weapons in Act 1 of Baldur's Gate 3.